just as we can define subtraction as adding a negation, we can define division as multiplying by a reciprocal. That seems a little fishy, doesn't it? Let's check it out with a couple simple examples to make sure this really works out. Let's try with x and y both as 2. 2 divided by 2. That's pretty easy. Should come out to be 1. 2 divided by 2. I'm going to use my definition here. 2 times the reciprocal of 2. Well, the reciprocal of 2, that's just a number you multiply by 2 to get 1. So we know that 2 times the reciprocal of 2 is 1. And as planned, 2 divided by 2 comes out to be 1. I don't buy it. Let's try another example. 14 divided by 2. All right, that should come out to be 7. So let's try our definition. This should be 14 times the reciprocal of 2. What do I do with that? The only thing I know about the reciprocal of 2 is when I multiply it by 2, I get 1. So I do know how to multiply this by 2, just not by 14. I could break 14 into 7 and 2, because 14 is 7 times 2. So I can write this as 7 times 2 times 1 over 2. And this I know how to compute. 2 times 1 over 2, that's 1. So that's 7 times 1, and sure enough, 14 divided by 2 comes out to be 7. Okay, so it's worked on 2 examples, so it must work on all of them. Okay, that's not a great conclusion to draw, but this is our definition of division. 14 divided by 2 is 14 times the reciprocal of 2. And that is how we define division in a way that allows us to deal with negatives. In fact, it lets us deal with almost any number, as we'll see. So how do we do this? 30 divided by negative 6. Well, we use our definition. Definition of division tells us that this is 30 times the reciprocal of negative 6. Well, the reciprocal of negative 6, you know what that is? That's just the negative of 1 over 6. And, well, positive times a negative, that's a negative, so this will be the negative of 30 times the reciprocal of 6. Multiplication by a reciprocal. That's the same thing as division. From our very definition of division, 30 times 1 over 6 is 30 divided by 6. Because that's our definition of division. And so 30 divided by 6, we know what that is. That's just 5. And this comes out to be negative 5. So we take a positive 30, divide by a negative 6, and we get a negative 5. And anytime we take a positive number and divide by a negative number, we'll go through steps just like these, and we'll end up with a negative result. Positive divided by negative equals a negative. Now, what happens if we start with a negative number and divide by a negative number? Well, I'm going to cheat a little bit here. I don't feel like writing all these steps again, so I'm just going to edit a little bit. So take this in here. Positive divided by negative equals a negative. And watch what happens when we have a negative divided by a negative. Don't try this at home. Trained professional. I'm going to cheat a little bit, and I'm going to pretend our starting number was negative and see how that changes everything down here. Well, that would mean this is also negative, so that's negative. And so this is negative as well. So if negative times a negative, that's positive. So this is positive. This is positive. Step stays the same. 30 times 1 over 6, definition of division, 30 divided by 6, makes this positive as well. All right, so negative divided by a negative. Reciprocal of negative 6 is negative of 1 over 6. Negative times a negative is a positive. And positive 30 times 1 over 6 is 30 divided by 6, leaves us positive 5. Negative divided by a negative is a positive. And you can go through steps pretty much just like this to see that negative divided by a positive, that comes out to be negative 2. So division with positive negatives works a lot like multiplication. And that makes sense because we define division as multiplication times a reciprocal here. All right, so we got negatives down. We've got positives down. You know what's next. Zero. All right. Take zero and divide that by 7. And we get 0 times the reciprocal of 7. And that's simple. 0 times anything is 0. We're done. Let's see. That is 0. So if I take 0 and divide by a positive number, I'm going to get 0. If I take 0 and divide by a negative number, I'm going to get 0. Because 0 times anything is 0. But for my last trick, I got to get ready here. You definitely can't try this last trick at home, all right? I am a trained professional. So don't try our last trick at home. 0 divided by 7, last trick. 7 divided by 0. All right, here we go. See if I can do this. Get warmed up. Yeah. All right. Trained professional. Don't try this at home. 7 divided by 0. 7 times the I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't take the reciprocal of 0. Even though I'm a trained professional, can't take the reciprocal of 0, so I can't divide by 0. And that means you can't divide by 0 either. See the shirt I'm wearing here? It's for the Canada-USA math camp, and I think they only have 3 rules at this summer camp. You know what those 3 rules are? Rule 1, no fire. Yeah, okay, that's a good rule. Rule 2, be excellent to each other. That's a great rule. And rule 3, no division by 0.